These two men are the new vice presidents of Zimbabwe. The appointment ended a power struggle that's left a trail of destruction, but which has also raised expectations. I sought to find out what the man on the street makes of the rapid changes in Zimbabwe's political landscape.
It is fundamental in that it has solved that succession question, which has almost crippled the functioning of government, especially if you look at the developments of the last 2 or so months, where there was a lot of contestation, where the business of government was forgotten.
I'm sure the president knows the character of the people that he has chosen and what happened between him and the former leaders. All I'm interested in is peace in the country.
We are not sure about the history of some of the new people that have been appointed, but the previous leadership that has been removed had a track record.
These days, Zimbabweans are either talking politics or the economy, so inevitably, people here have demands for the new team.
It's a good thing that we have new leaders in place, but we hope that they prioritize resuscitation of industries because there is too much unemployment.
The ascendancy of Mnangagwa comes at the expense of Joice Mujuru, who can still bounce back if she retains the popularity she enjoyed before her spectacular fall. Mujuru opened her heart in this response to allegations leveled against her, all of which she denies. She also maintains her loyalty to ZANU-PF, so leaving to start her own party is not an option. Analysts think she's likely to lay low for now.
This does not mean the end of her political career, or this does not mean that the Mujuru faction is suddenly going to become politically extinct. They will wait for Mugabe to exit the political stage, and then they will try to resurrect themselves.
For now though, Mugabe is set to consolidate his control of ZANU-PF to ensure fissures similar to the ones experienced in the last few months are not seen again. Farai Mwakutuya, CCTV, Harare, Zimbabwe.